Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you today from your brother from another mother. I hope you guys are all doing all right. Been, you know, busy with all the traveling and visiting people, praise God. I've been waiting to make this video. The Lord has been showing me, brothers and sisters, so many things. Like I said, I'm always thinking that, you know, I always drop a lot of words that the Lord gives me into my regular videos. And it's for those, you know, who are seeking, you know, discipleship and growth in the Lord that I cast these pearls before. There's just so many people, brothers and sisters, who are running to and fro on YouTube, as we know. And as I always say, you know, they're a mile wide and a half inch deep, as we say. They're very shallow, not seeking the wisdom of God or the things of God, but they want to harvest where someone else has sown and devour the food that belongs to the wise virgins. It belongs to the sheep of the Lord. And brothers and sisters, that's what I want to tell you, that those days are about to end. The deceptions in the life, and you know, the deceptions that are coming in our lives is about to end, brothers and sisters. And that's the message that I have from the Lord to the bride, the five wise virgins. I have set you free. You are free. The Lord is calling us to fly and come to Him. Now, what is that? That's the rapture. The Lord is calling us to come up here. Now, I'll probably make another video later on tonight after I do some more praying. A more bold video about this topic, brothers and sisters. Right now, I'm just doing a low-keyed one. Because I want to talk to my brothers and sisters in Christ, those who are part of the bride. You know, of course we all have, but me as a pastor, of an ordained minister, you know, of the gospel, you know, and I went to the seminary and all that stuff. I've endured the nonsense that's been on YouTube. Now, I don't watch it, but I have people asking me about it every day. All of the wacky nonsense, brothers and sisters, of people mocking the rapture. You know, mocking the Bible and mocking the theology of the bride of Christ, that the true church, the true born-again church that will be raptured, is the bride of Christ. All of these doctrines that are come from the Bible, like the word, like rapture. I just do one little example here. People say the word rapture is not in the Bible. Well, brothers and sisters, the word Bible is not in the Bible, and the word theology, Trinity is not in the Bible. Theology is not in the Bible. So, these are doctrines. So, as an example, the word rapture, you know, as I've said many times, comes from the Latin word that means to the harpozo, that's just the Greek word to be snatched up, to be caught up. That the Lord is going to do at the rapture, which comes from the Bible. And it's one of the main texts is 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, 18. And then you also have 1 Corinthians chapter 15, John chapter 14. Lots of verses, brothers and sisters. Anyhow, the time for discussing doctrine is over. The time for the Lord to bring His bride home is at hand. And that's the word I have from the Lord. He set us free, and He's going to call us to fly, to come up to Him, brothers and sisters. We will go to the Lord very soon, sooner than you think. And another word that I got from the Lord is sooner than you think. It's sooner than you think. So I just wanted to share two dreams that I had. And I always, you know, I said this in my videos, and I just want to say this again. You know, dreams can be just dreams. I'm convinced in my own heart that these dreams are from the Lord. But they are dreams. And no man's dream or vision supersedes the Word of God. So I want to say that again. Now these are the two dreams that I had. And then the Lord had told me when I was praying and hearing from Him and praying, like when I met Brother Gary, Brother Bear there. You know, and we had talked on the phone and prayed two or three times, and I keep getting the word from the Lord that it's sooner than you think. Not sooner than Gary thinks, but me. Because I'm one of those people that I'm not just standing around. You know, my focus is not, I need to, you know, to get rapture, to escape, you know, my own life. And that's the problem with lots of our brothers and sisters, and probably many of you who are watching this, who are rapture ready. A lot of people want to be raptured because, you know, their life is a big mess and they've got all these problems and whatever it may be. And they're ready to go right now for those reasons. But for me, I want to be raptured because I want to be with Jesus. But secondarily, I'm willing to stay here as long as it takes because I'm a pastor and I want to, you know, win all those people and get all those people who are going to go in the rapture ready. To make people rapture ready. That's what my mission is from God. To disciple people. And that's what I'm going to do. So my focus is for that. But anyway, so I'm one of those people that, well, if, you know, I'm believing the rapture will be in my own personal mind. In my mind, I'm thinking that the rapture could still be several years away. Two or three. When I say several, two or three, something like that. I don't know. We don't know. No man knows the day or the hour. But the Lord keeps telling me that it's sooner than we think. You know, before I dismiss the blood moons as, you know, because they're a scheduled event. And then the Lord said, no, these are significant. Lots of things. The Lord has shown me, you know, supernaturally that this is an important time period. So I had these two dreams. And I've had others. I just want to do these two right now because I had them kind of back to back just in the last week. I had a dream that I was looking down into this well. And in this well, it was full of water. And then there were all these 23s floating in the water. 23s, a whole bunch of them. And then I stood over it and I was looking. There was a bunch of people there, Christians. And I was looking down into that well of water, or, you know, it was like a pond, a rock enclosed pond or well. And I was looking in there and I looked down and I said, hey, this number's too much. We need to lower this number. So in my mind, in my dream, I was thinking it's like the pH of the water is too high. We need to lower this. But I kept saying in the dream, this is too high, this is too high. And so I told people to throw in lower numbers. And the people were throwing in all these numbers, which I couldn't see. They were just throwing them into the water. And I said, we'll get this right. It's going to be balanced. And then suddenly a great big 13 came up in the middle of the water. And I woke up. And then I saw, and I was thinking, what is this? Is this, the pH of the water? Or is it states, like the 23rd state and the 13th state? What is this? And then the Lord showed me in a vision when I woke up, a night vision, as I woke up, my eyes were still closed. I saw somebody doing a shadow puppet of, you know, doing like we do shadows on the wall. You make your hands and do a shadow. So I saw that, a big hand making a shadow, then the shadow is on the wall. So the Lord was telling me, hey, this is a shadow of things. And so, of course, I already should have known that. I got up and I started moving around and then the Lord just began to reveal to me, he's talking about dates. The Lord just spoke to me, he's talking about dates. They're talking about 23rd September versus 13th of December, of September. Now, I don't have all the days locked in for the holidays. I talked to Brother Gary. I mean, I know about when they are. I was thinking the 23rd was one of those days. And then the 13th is also one of those Jewish holidays. And so, you know, that seems to be what the Lord is alluding to. Okay. So I had called Gary and we talked about it because I was already back here. That was the day after I saw Gary. So then the next day, so it's been two or three days, I've been, you know, pondering making the video and I was actually so tired out from my trip I didn't feel like doing it, but the Lord has told me to go ahead and make the video. But so anyway, the next night I had a dream, and in this dream there was a girl. In this dream, I was in some kind of a house. I don't remember all the details right now. I need to pray about it more. But I kept hearing this noise, and I didn't know what the noise was. You know, and when I went outside, I heard the noise, and I looked up, and it was somebody was bowling in the sky, you know, like a bowling ball and bowling pins. But I'd been hearing this ball rolling and hitting, and then when I saw it, I was like, yeah, that's what the noise is. It's somebody bowling. I don't know why I didn't recognize it before. Thought it was thunder or rumbling and all this. So I went outside and someone was bowling, and it was a young girl like Goldilocks, and or you know, like Hansel and Gretel. She was dressed in traditional looking clothes from the 1800s or something, with like a dress and then a white apron over the top of it. And she had like goldy locks. She had like goldish, like dirty, hers was actually like a dirty blondish looking, brownish blondish looking hair, not so brightly golded, but anyhow, traditional looking clothes. And she was bowling that bowling ball. Now I want to say, I think that that girl is Germany. And I believe it's significant because, let me tell you what happened. She rolled that ball, and then when I looked at the other end, there were all these bowling pins. And check this out. This is so wild. Every one of the pins, brothers and sisters, was an event with a date. Now, the bad news is, I'll say up front, the bad news is I couldn't focus in on the dates but one pin, the first pin. The other pins, I could not see the dates clearly. You know, I could just almost make it out. And, of course, the Lord wasn't letting me. Maybe the Lord will let me. So I ask you guys to pray that the Lord will let me see those other pins. But the first pin, brothers and sisters, it shocked me when the ball rolled and hit that pin. And like I said, I believe it's coming from Europe. Of course, the European situation with their with Greece and all that. The sign totally shocked me. It said August the 18th. American financial crisis, August 18th, American financial crisis. And it shocked me because it was sooner than I thought. I mean, that was the shocking part to me, that the date was not September or whatever, but August 18th. So I had that dream two or three days ago. And then I woke up before I could, I was trying to look at the other pins, but I woke up. The Lord didn't let me see the dates on the other pins. But that thing about it, brothers and sisters, is that pin was the first pin. And you know, when you knock down the first pin, it knocks down the other one. So in other words, it's a sequence of events that kicks off with American financial crisis. Now, since that day, it's been two or three days ago, now there are some stuff that's, you know, in the news about financial stuff going on in the U.S. You know, it's going there. So the Lord had led me. I'd looked at this, I looked at something that this prophecy of David Wilkerson, and no, I don't have the link. You have to look these things up yourself. And go look at David Wilkerson had a dream in the 1970s. Somebody can put the link on here if they want to. And he was basically, you know, at, you know, the Lord led me to it. And if you look at it, he talks about, you know, capital controls and all that. Like what they're doing in Greece where, you know, you can't get money out of the bank too much and all that. So I think that that's a prudent thing to do until between that day and when the rapture happens. It can't hurt to have some cash at home on hand, brothers and sisters. That's what I would say. But, I don't know how many days it'll be. Now, I haven't really said anything like that before because, of course, the Lord will provide for us. That's true. If you have no money, you know, God can make manna rain out of the sky or whatever he wants to do. There's no doubt, brothers and sisters. So we have total faith and trust in the Lord. That's why I don't usually like to... That's the problem with these post-tribbers, you know, and these people that don't believe in the pre-tribulation rapture. Fear-mongering. Fear-mongering. And I never go there because just like I started this video, brothers and sisters... The thing I said at the beginning of this video, God, the Lord, Jesus Christ has set us free. He set us free from the law of sin and death, the Bible says. Jesus said, those whom the Son sets free are free indeed. So the Lord has set us free from these things, and he will provide for us. He will, you know, he will hide us in the cleft of the rock. You know, he will provide for us. He will deliver us from the snare of the fowler. That's, I'm saying this right now from the Spirit of the Lord. He will deliver us from those things to come upon the earth. Revelation 3:10, Luke 21:36. The Lord knows how to deliver his own, and he will deliver us and save us to the uttermost. Those who are part of the five wise virgins. Don't believe this stories where people say that you know, you can say a sinner's prayer, live like hell all your life, and go to heaven. I want to warn those people too. I need to make videos about that. And I made video about videos many times in the past. Don't be deceived. Don't be fooled. If you're a true born-again child of God, don't get into the fear-mongering of these people either. Because there is an escape. The Lord will snatch his people from this earth. The answer to every problem, every situation is the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ. It's the escape. So don't let, if you know, if you're unrepented, then yeah, you need to have fear. If you're right with God, prayed up with God and repented, then of course there is no fear. Perfect love casts out all fear, the Bible says. So now if you are living in sin, well, of course, yeah, you need to go watch. If you're not rapture ready, you need to go watch Anita Fuentes, and you need to watch Paul Begley and learn all about and Steve Quayle and all these guys and get all caught up in how to survive until they chop your head off. If you at that time you choose to repent or take the mark. So you need to get all into all those things. But if you want to go in the rapture, you need to repent right now and get right with God. Turn from your wicked ways. 2 Chronicles 7:14. Seek his face, turn from your wicked ways, that your ways may be pleasing to him. 1 John 2. Hallelujah. Hebrews 11. He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. I'm going to come back later on tonight and make a preaching video, brothers and sisters. It's too late in the game to be tangling with these people. I just got to tell the truth. These people mocking the bride, mocking the rapture, they're going to be weeping. There's going to be weeping and gnashing of teeth. They'll be weeping and gnashing their teeth. That's all I can say. God bless you guys. I love all of you, brothers and sisters in Christ. God bless you all.